Yeah, Sai. Today's video is very special for me because I want to share something from deep within my heart with all of you. But before I do that, I want you to answer some questions for me. My first question. Think of a situation where a girl meets a boy and for the first time because they want to get married and this is their first meeting and they like each other. So they decide that we should keep meeting now a few times to know each other better so that we can take a decision on the wedding. They decide that we will meet for 5 minutes every 15 days. You heard me right, 5 minutes. Once in 15 days, just for those 5 minutes. How long will it take for them to know each other? That's my question for you. You can answer it to yourself. My second question. You decide to pick up a hobby or learn something new. Maybe it is music or art or swimming or painting or any other thing that you want to learn. And then you decide that I must take time out for this, you know. If I have to bring this into my life, I will have to spare time. And then you decide that once in 30 days, I will spend 5 minutes on this work. Will you ever be able to learn it? Yes or no? All right, enough of questions. I just hope your kids don't come and tell you that Mama, I'll study 5 minutes or Papa, I'll study 5 minutes in 10 days for my exam. That will be enough. They have to give more time, right? Now comes my main reason for doing today's video. This journey of life that we have come for, we came alone and we go from here absolutely alone. I come as an individual soul. I live my journey, the journey of my soul. And then I go as beautifully as I came, silently, alone, just as I came alone. Yes, there is family. Yes, there is. When a soul comes to this earth, it comes with family karma, society karma, collective karma, world karma. There are so many aspects of it. So the soul has certain connections and obligations towards family, towards society, towards country, towards world. Depending on your soul plan, it can grow bigger. So that is something that we associate with other people and other souls. But actually, I have come for my journey. This is my journey of my soul unto myself. And that is why we say that this is my journey. And ultimately, I want to reach the stage of self-realization because it's my journey with myself. I have come to live my karma, to go through my experiences, to learn my lessons so that my soul grows and evolves. And when it does, that is where I get on the path of self-realization. So it is a journey to know myself, self-realization. I have to know myself. Now comes my final question for you. This is your journey of your soul with yourself, unto yourself. You've come here so that you can realize your own self. How much time do you spend with yourself? Well, before I recorded this video, I asked a lot of my friends and people I know this question, and they were shocked. There was silence on the other side. Do we even spend 5 minutes with our own selves today? Very remote, very rare. If you do spend those 5 minutes also, the phone is in our hand, the TV is switched on, there is disturbance, there are other thoughts, 100 other things in my mind constantly. So even when I am with myself, I'm actually not with myself, which means even if I'm alone, I'm not present in that moment. I am in so many other places but for that moment where I should be. So this beautiful series of Aham Brahmasmi that I'm bringing forth for you is a journey unto myself. It is every soul's journey within. Every soul has come here for a purpose, for a reason, and I cannot go unfulfilled from here. I cannot go incomplete and unfulfilled. You know, before we come, our soul chooses a plan, a soul plan, a life plan. And when we come into our mother's womb, we come with that blueprint very clear in our minds, in our very naive and beautiful and unpolluted, uncorrupted, pure minds that we come with. You know, we carry all that blueprint with us. As we grow up, we get conditioned by people around us, by family, by society, by education, and our mind goes outward. and we actually forget that blueprint which we came with. And Aham Brahmasmi is about going back to your blueprint, about knowing why did I come here? What was my soul's journey? Have I forgotten something? Is life giving me messages and I'm ignoring them? Am I being given the direction and not getting, you know, and not understanding this is the direction my life has to take, my soul has to take? Are the lessons coming over and over and repeating themselves as a pattern? And am I not learning that, oh, these are my life lessons that I have come to learn? There is so much to know about my own self that I don't. And trust me, the journey is absolutely stunningly beautiful, because when I get to know my own soul, when my life plan unfolds before me, when my soul's, you know, decision which it took before it came here unfolds before me, and I realize, oh my God, this is why I came to this earth. That purpose may be something very, very, let me not go into what the purpose is going to be, but it can be so much close to you, yet you may not have realized it, or then you may be totally away from it and totally digressed away from the purpose, not realizing that you're giving away your energies and resources to the wrong path, which is not your path. It's time we get to our path, and then it is time we start spending time with our own selves. Because if I have to know myself, if I have to reach the stage of self-realization, and after self-realization is moksha, is nirvana, is merging into your guru, your God. To reach that stage, there are several steps I must take. Aham Brahmasmi is those steps that we will take unto ourselves, a journey within my own self. Looking forward to holding your hands and walking you through this journey. It's going to be very, very beautiful, I promise you. Yasai.